Nationwide Children's Hospital is one of a handful of pediatric facilities that offers both capsule endoscopy and double balloon enteroscopy. We were asked to see a 13-year-old young lady that was referred to us with the development of polyposis throughout her gastrointestinal tract. These are images of the upper duodenum and identify the initial polyps that were first encountered. Biopsies of these lesions showed evidence of high-grade dysplasia. Due to the location of this polyp, capsule endoscopy identified several suspicious lesions. We had to take several approaches to try to secure it properly. At double balloon enteroscopy in the duodenum and jejunum, four polyps, as shown here, were identified. Due to the angle of the polyp, we had to manipulate the scope, oftentimes only taking off pieces of the polyp, but eventually removing the entire lesion. This allowed us to identify or examine these polyps under the microscope to make sure that they weren't cancerous. The next case I'd like to discuss with you was an 8-year-old young lady that was referred to us here at Nationwide Children's Hospital for the evaluation of anemia. Her capsule endoscopy study identified a suspicious lesion in the middle of the small intestine. And in order to further delineate what this lesion was, she underwent double balloon enteroscopy. After a distance of approximately 140 to 150 centimeters, an area of concern was encountered. Early on, it had an irregular mass-like appearance. And at that time, we couldn't determine whether or not this was a mass within the wall of the small intestine or was something outside the wall that had invaded or pressed into the bowel wall. Due to the appearance and nature of this lesion, the possibility of a malignancy was seriously considered, and consultation with pediatric surgery was obtained while the patient was still in the operating room, such that they could come and see what we were seeing at the time of the study. Surprisingly, no other tumor markers were noted in the blood work, and it was ultimately decided to proceed with surgery. A vascular abnormality known as a hemangioma was identified on the outside surface of the bowel wall, which was classic and explained this kind of lesion. This young lady underwent a small, limited resection of the involving intestine and made a complete and uneventful recovery.